When we're analyzing AC circuits, or when we're looking at amplifier circuits in particular, it often makes things a little bit simpler to separate the DC part of the circuit from the AC part of the circuit. When we look at the AC part of the circuit, we ground the DC power supplies. Now, why do we do that? Let's look at an example. And what I'd like to do is find the input impedance of this amplifier circuit. We know that for an amplifier, it's advantageous to have a high input impedance. How could I go about finding the input impedance to this amplifier? First of all, I might notice that it's a common emitter amplifier. I know that it's a common emitter because the emitter of the amplifier is not connected to either the input or the output. It's common to those. So it's common emitter configuration. But again, in this video, I really want to concentrate on finding the input impedance. By inspection, I can say that the input impedance is approximately R1 in parallel with R2. In other words, I have a branch going up here, and I have a branch going down here. I'm kind of ignoring the branch going into the base of that transistor because I happen to know that the impedance looking into the base of a transistor tends to be very large. So if I add a large resistor in parallel with two smaller resistors, then it's not going to change the answer too much. So the input impedance here is essentially R1 in parallel with R2. How can I say, though, that the 10 volts can be treated like a ground? In other words, it's very clear that R2 is connected to ground, but from the perspective of an AC signal, why do I know that R1 is connected to a ground? Because the circuit that I've just drawn clearly shows that R1 is indeed in parallel with R2, but why could I ground the 10-volt source? Isn't there something wrong with doing that? Let me show you exactly why we can do that. Why can we treat the 10-volt DC power supply source as a ground when we're calculating input or output impedance? To answer that question, I'd like to look at a simple circuit. We're not going to be looking at an amplifier here. We're just going to be looking at two simple voltage dividers. Let's assume that I have an AC source that has an amplitude of 1 volt peak to peak. I'm going to attach it to 2 1-kilo-ohm resistors. My input voltage, so to speak, is 1 volt peak to peak. And now I can ask the question, what's the voltage between these two resistors? Well, I don't even have to calculate it. I think it should be clear that we have a voltage divider here. The voltage is going to divide evenly between these 2 1-kilo-ohm resistors, so the peak-to-peak voltage right in between them should be 0.5 volt. That was a straightforward example. I now want to modify the circuit a little bit to introduce a DC source. We're going to keep our AC source the same, and we're still going to have it attached to a 1 kilo-ohm resistor. At our output side, though, I'm not going to attach a 1 kilo-ohm resistor to ground. Instead, I'm going to attach it to a 10-volt power supply. I'm now going to ask the same question. What's the amplitude of my AC signal at this point? Well, in order to simplify things, I'm going to redraw it to show clearly that my 10-volt rail is indeed a DC source. I have two different sources, and I want to know what the voltage V is between the 2 1-kilo-ohm resistors. Do you remember how we might be able to find voltages in circuits, linear circuits that is, when we have multiple sources? You can use superposition, can't you? Superposition allows us, in linear circuits anyway, to zero out one source in order to find the contribution of another source. We can then zero out the other source, find the contribution to the first source, and then combine them together. That's what we're going to do here in this circuit. We're going to zero out these sources one by one to find the contribution due to each of them. First, let's find the contribution at the output side due to the AC source. I can ground my DC source, can't I? That's the principle of superposition. Voltage V due to the AC source is just what it was in example 1, 0.5 volt peak to peak. It's an AC signal. Let's find the contribution due to the 10-volt source. I can zero out my AC source. The voltage due to the 10-volt source is going to be 5 volts because it's an even voltage divider. My total voltage, to go back and write the answer, is going to be 5 volts, that's the DC component, and then it's going to have an AC component with 0.5 volt peak to peak, or 1/4 volt in amplitude sine wave. When we're doing AC analysis in circuits, though, we don't often care what the DC part of the signal is, because if we look back at amplifiers, we often have capacitors that block off these components anyhow. When we're finding the AC gain, for example, we might not care if there's some DC component to our signal. We really care about the AC gain or the amplitude right here. That's essentially why when we're working with amplifiers and we're really interested in finding AC gain, we can pretty much just treat power supplies as AC grounds.